Hello students, I am Professor Nimit Chaudhary from Jamia Millia Islamia, your instructor for this module. Welcome back to the course on destination management. We bring this course to you as part of e-Pathshala initiative of the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, to make postgraduate education accessible to all. In this module, we'll talk about organizing for the management of destination. The President and CEO of St. Francis Convention and Visitors Bureau has once said in 2004 that the primary reasons cities created destination management or marketing organization has not changed in more than last 100 years, which is bring in the business. Tourism is always a growing business and has far-reaching economic and environmental impact across the world. For a successful business in tourism industry, there is a plan for many managers and planners of destination, which is considered as DMOs, the destination management or marketing organizations or corporations. The responsibilities of these organizations start from the identification of the possible destination attractions for tourists through proper and planned development of the destinations to promote the destination among the prospective crowd. The previous module has presented a crucial role of these organizations, which are marketing a destination, developing a strategy and creating a sustainable plan for the development of the destination. This module will connect you with another dimensions of the DMOs, that is how the organizational structure works for the destination developments and what are the different forms of destination organizations to promote a destination to a tourist. In this module, we'll see how the organizations have emerged to oversee the development of destinations. Diversified and variety of roles and responsibilities are present in destination management and marketing organizations. The methods to play these roles and fulfill various responsibilities associated varies as per country. Moreover, they are split and decided between national, provincial, regional and local levels. In general, the national level is concerned with more strategic part, that is planning part, and local level is concerned in the implementation part, that is how planning will have transformed as execution of the strategies. The UNWTO has summarized the responsibilities of DMOs as in the table on your screen. Regional DMO is the linking pin between the national and local DMOs. The multi-level nature of the tourism support structure is reflected in the figure on your screen, which we refer to as the sunflower solution. In the diagram, the sun is the National Tourism Authority, whose rays strategic programs of activities are benign. It means national enablers are the ones who pens down the planning required. Existing competition act as winds and storms, which is unwelcome but equally unavoidable and also necessary if destinations are to remain focused. At a regional level or in some countries, sub-regional level, the DMO should actively engage all its various stakeholders. DMO plays an essential role in the private sector and is considered as a significant one. Although DMO has its own funding base as far as their marketing budgets are concerned, nevertheless, its role of connecting national agencies and the industry on the ground remains essential and outstanding. This is an important role. While the National Tourism Authority will almost certainly be the single most significant tourism marketer, the collective spend of the industry will be much higher. It is the regional DMO that brings together public and private resources to reinforce common strategic approach. More can be achieved by spending the same amount of money. DMO also plays the role of a coordinator at the local level, as it fully engages the tourism business in its programs, thus coordinating the role in tourism activity at the local level. However, the DMOs need to develop strong local connections through the mechanism of local tourism groups. Such groups should bring together the full range of organizations that have a role to play in the handling the destination to deliver a high quality of experience. Further, joint destination management plans and their implementations at the local level is undertaken by the regional or sub-regional DMO. They coordinate and facilitate the work of its partners through this system if the preparation of a joint destination plan and by overseeing implementation of related tourism. The planning and its implementation would remain incomplete in case the DMO overlooks the proposition presented by the local stakeholders. Therefore, DMO must ensure all local stakeholders view and embrace them in the planning and implementation process. Thus, DMO in the addition ensures the listening and adding value and establishing structures to allow a top-down bottom approach equilibrium to be achieved, referred to as listening leadership. The listening leadership approach ensures the high success rate of the plans and sunflower head is likely to bloom to its full potential. There are some options for the governance of destination management and can be used as per the circumstances and their availability as follows. Single authority, that is the department of single public authority. Complementary alliances, that is partnership of public authority serviced by the partners. Joint ventures, that is partnership of public authorities serviced by joint management unit. Outsourcing, wherever needed, that is public authorities outsourcing delivery to private companies. Public-private partnerships for specific functions, often in the form of a non-profit making company, and privatization, that is association of company funded purely by private sector partnership and trading, again for specific functions. For each type of governance, there will be particular strengths and weaknesses, and these are outlined here. Some of the strengths of the public sector are based on long-term strategic approach, working on quality assurance, destination awareness creation as an integral role, public realm management that is more focused on the needs of general public and locals, SMME support. Let us now consider the strength of the private sector. Short-term yet tactical approach, sales focus and more target oriented, based on customer relationship management, focus on market opportunities, rapid decision making, entrepreneurial skills. However, the public sector has some weaknesses as well. Among them are lacks sharp focus on delivering new business with innovation and creativity, poor at generating commercial income and imprecise on professional front, risk averse and unenthusiastic towards new ideas, tolerates poor performance, conventional and slow to take decisions, distrust private sector and the profit motive. Private sector on the other hand has its own set of weaknesses, lacks apprehension for the wider public good, that is more public oriented, limited interest in planning for the longer term, has inadequate resources, frustrated by public sector practices. Undoubtedly, both public and private sectors can do miracles together as they have much to offer. It would not be wrong to quote the core competencies of both the sectors, that is public sector provides a holistic and longer term strategic role to ensure quality, while the public sector acts swiftly and tactfully to develop its business. These strengths and weaknesses emphasize the importance of partnerships and to develop synergies where the whole is greater than the sum of the parts. There are several ways by which private players support the destination management. These differ as per the type of governance. The relationship of public-private by type of governance is as shown on your screen. DMOs play a significant leadership role in the functioning of a destination management. A holistic view of destination management needs a partnership between public and private sector, the government and different organizations involved. DMO at one level should allow different stakeholders locally to identify with its aims and purposes to be effective at the marketplace or collect adequate budget for its functioning. The organization structure should be multidimensional, one at the marketplace and one at the ground level while delivering. Delivering the strategy and the destination management plan. The DMO's prime role is to develop, implement and the agreed tourism strategy. The role needs contributions from public, private and third party players to cooperate in the complete process. Destination management plan is the critical mechanism for joint action planning and budgeting. Putting forth a strategy, a joint plan by all organizations for a period of 3 to 5 years together. A partnership mechanism will be needed involving all organizations, public and private, to plan, develop and deliver the strategy of the destination management plan. This may be termed as tourism planning and development group. Next is the business planning and budgeting. The destination management plan and the strategy involved provide the platform and the initial point for DMO's business plan. The operational wing of the destination management and marketing extends beyond the role of the DMOs. However, DMOs as a pillar act as a leader to achieve the holistic development and the proper implementation of its activities. The business plan should resolve all the queries of the standard business planning, such as where are we, where do we want to go, what's the way to reach there, moreover, how we will know that we have arrived at the right position. Usually, the public sector funds the DMO. DMOs need to achieve some standards to seek exit route where they are expected to be self-sustaining, but that expectation is usually not realistic and reasonable. While the expectation from the private sector to pay for the destination marketing activities is reasonable, the broader and strategic role for long-term development help private and public sectors to consistently deliver best experiences to visitors. The other expectation is from the public sector for the establishment of the organization and to bear the cost of poor staff and office expenses. The private sector classified activities designed to give them direct should be paid for through their contributions towards marketing activities, advertising on web and in publication, attendance at exhibitions, etc. Commercial trading activities, for example, commission and the fees involved in bookings, and membership fees where a membership structure is considered appropriate. The basic principles of above type agreement should support the DMO business planning and budgeting process. It should be well clarified in the state level agreement that the public sector should meet the establishment cost in return for strategical activity. DMO should focus on the delivery part of the tourism services instead of bothering for funding, which is in reality the fate of most of the DMOs. The DMO should be empowered and motivated to manage itself and deliver the planned activities for the destination through engaging all the involved communities to their future benefit and the comfortable and exciting stay of the visitors. Let us now consider the standards for governance of DMOs to assure standards can be accredited for various aspects of their operations. For example, universal standards established for DMO operations at Destination Marketing Association International, the DMAI, through DMAP, which is Destination Marketing Accreditation Program. DMAP regulates the stakeholders' functional standards for DMOs. On the other hand, the UNWTOS provides certification of excellence for tourism governance at all the three levels, local, regional and national level. If UNWTOS standards are met, the certified tourism governance institution can become leaders through continuous brand enhancement. Certification of UNWTOS is the primary indicator for tourism development. The overall objective of UNWTOS certification is to assist tourism governance institutions in achieving best practices in governance. The best practices, if achieved, have a positive effect on national tourism functions, and it may serve as a model for others to follow. These UNWTOS practices have a significant effect on the society as well as private players involved in the destination development. To meet the UNWTOS standards, every year an audit is being carried out by the independent entity to ensure the tourism governance at the different levels. This audit process for UNWTOS best standard is to check the and maintain the quality in different areas of tourism governance, such as the institutional relationship with the society, institutional relationship with other stakeholders, the corporate and strategic management, the development and implementation of the program, human resource management, for other resources, that is financial and infrastructure. UNWTO SBEST certification awarded to 6 governance institutions. The first 6 organizations promoting tourism which were awarded SBEST certification by UNWTO were: 1. Blackstone River Valley in USA, 2. State of Tabasco in Mexico, 3. San Martin de los Andes from Argentina, 4. KwaZulu Natal from South Africa, 5. The city of Valencia from Spain, and 6. Cancun from Mexico. The other things which resulted in these organizations winning awards were: improving sustainable tourism, self-improvement and development projects in the area, promoting active involvement with all stakeholders, involving the local community, good practices regarding financial resources and infrastructure management, investment in human capital and training. Next is monitoring and evaluation. Assessment of past actions plays a significant role in the lessons by correcting the future actions. These assessments should be positive. These should help projects being assessed to deliver somewhat than merely being critical assessments of historical activities. Being positive is indispensable to the assessment process. Assessments which are positive will be observed by those individuals assessed both as less intimidating and obliging to their energies to improving their projects. It plays a significant role. The individuals provide cooperation to which assessor, which is considered, is tremendously vital. If the assessment is to be efficaciously achieved, the assessment obviously should also be objective. It is inevitably critical, and if compulsory, should be extremely important of all the parts in the project. If the process is positive and clear, the criticism would be accepted and absorbed by the sponsors of the project. The DMO should do the assessment process for not only assessing its packages but also of its stakeholders. If applied positively, the assessment could undoubtedly be helpful to all concerned authorities, stakeholders, and could assist the DMOs to achieve itself in the middle of the entire destination management process, which is the reason for its existence. Thus, given the nature of the complexities of the destination, it will have to choose a form of governance with varying degree of public and private initiatives. Students, thanks for being with us during this module. We'll meet again for the next module. Thank you.